गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स आर वेलकम टू वन मोर वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड न्यूमेरिकल ओरिएंटेड क्लास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक फील्ड थ्योरी एंड द टॉपिक दैट वी हैव कंटिन्यूड एज पर द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स ऑल ऑफ यू पीपल आर नोइंग द नेम ऑफ टॉपिक इज मैक्सवेल्स इक्वेशंस. सो फ्रेंड्स, एज ऑल ऑफ यू पीपल आर नोइंग that Maxwell's equation can be considered to be a very very important considering the behavior of electromagnetic waves. As all of we people are knowing that electromagnetic waves are constituted with electric field as well as magnetic field, the behavior of electromagnetic wave can be predicted or can be analyzed or can be studied effectively by understanding Maxwell's equations. So in previous lecture we had seen the introduction related to Maxwell's equations. So now in this lecture the main intention of our today's lecture routine will be to understand the equations numerically. For the same concern, here we have to consider few examples or numericals. So once again I would like to welcome all the students of TE ENTC class for the subject electromagnetic field theory, and here our today's topic is understanding Maxwell's equation by analytical, that is numerical method. There are different methods of study. If we are performing experiment, we can call the method as experimental method, as here we are learning the subject by understanding the mathematics behind them. It can be considered to be a analytical method. So friends, here we'll consider first example. Here let us assume that E bar is the electric field intensity that is described with 2y ay bar, and H bar, that is magnetic field intensity, is given by 5x ax bar. So here we have to check whether these two equations satisfy Maxwell's equation or not. For checking whether the given set of equations in example 1 are satisfying the Maxwell's equation or not, let us consider the four equations of set Maxwell's equation as described here. First equation is del dot B bar is equal to 0. Second equation is del dot D bar is equal to rho V. Third equation is del cross H bar is equal to J bar plus D bar dot. And fourth equation is del cross E bar is equal to minus B bar dot. As all of you people are knowing that two equations are having requirement of consideration of dot, that is nothing but divergence, and two equations having cross of del operator, that are nothing but consideration of curl of given electric and magnetic field intensity. So here in this example, initially they have given in the numerical representation that here sigma is equal to 0, and as sigma is equal to 0, all of you people are knowing that current density J bar is described as sigma E bar, where sigma is conductivity and E bar is the electric field intensity. As here sigma conductivity is 0, therefore J bar will be equal to 0. That's why we have to analyze the equation accordingly. Now in addition to the four equation as listed here, we have to note a few essential parameters for solving the numerical examples henceforth. So let us consider that in general D bar is equal to epsilon E bar and B bar is equal to mu H bar. That is, we are relating densities with intensities. If D bar is the electric flux density and E bar is electric field intensity, we can write d bar is equal to epsilon e bar and b bar is equal to mu h bar. Here in case of magnetic field parameters, we have to understand that b bar is indicating magnetic flux density and h bar is indicating the magnetic field intensities. As here we can represent d bar is electric flux density and e bar is electric field intensity. In a similar way, friends, we also have to remember that epsilon and mu, note here, very important points I am going to explain you. Epsilon and mu, this symbol is called as epsilon, whereas this symbol is called as mu. These two parameters are very important for the propagation of electromagnetic waves. Therefore, we have to write epsilon is equal to epsilon 0 into epsilon r and mu is equal to mu 0 into mu r. So what are these concerned parameters? If suppose we are considering air as the medium for propagation of any electromagnetic wave, under that case we can write this epsilon as epsilon 0 and mu as mu 0. But suppose if there is no any air medium and suppose that the experiment is carried over in a constrained environment, for example in presence of a specific gas container, or if in presence of a gas, or suppose that it is conducted or it is to be conducted under the influence of any oil, if in the under the influence of any solid or anything similar to that, then this mu and epsilon will be having a different value compared to air medium. Therefore mu r and epsilon r will be the terms related to the relative permittivity and relative permeability. In a more simpler words, we can say that in case of circuit theory, we know that there is the effect of resistance for voltage and current. In the same way, here in case of electromagnetic wave, we have to remember that instead of resistance for any media, two factors will be determining the propagation of electromagnetic wave, defined by mu and epsilon. Epsilon will be the factor which will be contributing to the propagation of electric field, and mu will be the factor affecting the magnetic field density or intensities. Therefore, keep in mind these two values, as like resistance is there in case of circuit theory, here there is permeability and permittivity for the consideration of field theory. Again, there are few essential parameters that I would like to add, so that if concepts of all these parameters are very clear at the start, there will not be any confusion at the time of solving numericals. As we know, d bar and e bar are density and intensities related to electrical fields. In the similar way, b bar and h bar will be the magnetic field density and magnetic field intensity for the electromagnetic wave. Let us proceed further. Though here these parameters are somewhat not clear, I will read it clearly so that everyone will be able to understand. Friend, here the same above parameters I had attempted to clarify once again. For any medium, whether there is air medium or any other sort of medium is there in which electromagnetic wave is going to propagate, here we have to consider three basic aspects of propagation of electromagnetic waves. First is conductivity of medium. how much medium is positive for the conduction of information signal, that can be denoted by sigma. In the same way, epsilon is nothing but permittivity of the medium, which is equal to epsilon 0 epsilon r. In case of air, epsilon r will be having value 1. Therefore, epsilon, that is permittivity, will be equal to only epsilon 0. Here also we have expressed here that epsilon 0 is the permittivity in air whose value is 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12. In the same way, here we again have expressed that in general medium, for the consideration of any general medium, epsilon r will be the permittivity of any medium. If suppose air medium is having epsilon r value 1, suppose that experiment is being performed in the gas or in any type of other medium, for that medium value of epsilon r will be different than the value 1. In the same way, it is the case for mu. For the magnetic field, here we can observe mu as the permeability of the medium, which is denoted by mu equal to mu 0 mu r, and mu 0 can be considered to be permeability of air whose value is 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7, and for mu r can be defined to be permeability of medium. The same slide can be visualized with a different study, can be shown here, and just try to remember that similar to resistance in a wire, electromagnetic wave gets opposition due to two parameters, namely electric field and magnetic field, which are described by permittivity and permeability. If permittivity and permeability are very less values, we can say that maximum electromagnetic wave can travel with the complete or the 100% information signal. But if suppose epsilon and mu, that is permittivity and permeability, if these factors are of higher range, they may affect the propagation of electromagnetic waves, and it will be critical to any electromagnetic wave to reach the destination appropriately. So considering this, once again come back to the example. Here we had been given that E bar is equal to 2y bar and H bar is equal to 5x ax bar, as we had seen on the first slide. So here let us start with the first equation to prove del dot B bar is equal to 0. To solve this equation or to verify this equation, let us consider the LHS. Here we can observe LHS is equal to del dot B bar. Again we can write here B bar is equal to mu H bar. As mu is a constant parameter that can be taken outside of divergence, and we can write del dot H bar. As per the information in previous lecture, we had defined this operator del as dou by dou x of ax component plus dou by dou y of ay component and dou by dou z of hz component or z direction component. So here anybody can observe that this electromagnetic wave or this specific wave, we are not yet defined whether it is satisfying Maxwell's equation or not, this wave is consisting of h bar in only ax bar direction. That's why other two derivatives or partial derivatives definitely will be contributing to 0, and can write the equation as mu as it is dou by dou x into the coefficient of ax bar as 5x. That can be taken here from h bar. If it is clear, we can observe that in this example they also have given mu equivalent to 10 into mu 0, which was not defined in the first slide, but here or henceforth we have to remember that mu is equal to 10 mu 0 as per the given data. And for the bracket, solving the derivative of 5x with respect to x, everybody know that derivative of x with respect to x will be 1. Therefore, 5 can be kept as it is, and overall it will be having value 5 into 10, 50 multiplied by value of mu 0 that just we had seen is equal to 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7. Whatever is the value, we can say that LHS is not equal to RHS. Now try to remember that for any set of equation E bar and H bar, we have to verify whether equation is described with Maxwell's equation, whether all Maxwell's equation are satisfied. We can say that the given set of equations are satisfying Maxwell's equation. Here, whatever is the value of this constant, as it is not equal to 0, we can write LHS is not equal to RHS. And I will directly say, as first equation do not satisfy Maxwell's condition, we directly can say that given set of equations do not satisfy Maxwell's equation. It is not required to check whether remaining equations satisfy Maxwell's equation or not. If we will consider that if all the remaining three equations, that is equation number 2, equation number 3 and equation number 4, if suppose these three equations are also satisfying Maxwell's equation, but as it is not satisfying first equation, we can say that given set of equations are not satisfying Maxwell's equation, as can be expressed here, which can be considered to be completion of our first example. Okay, it can be considered to be similar to our regular practice. If suppose there are four subjects in which you have to pass in the exam, and if suppose you are absent in the first exam, what will happen? There is no need to check your result by second paper, third paper and fourth paper. Directly result will be fail. In the similar manner, here we can say that if suppose one equation is not satisfying Maxwell's equation, we can directly say that given set of equation is not satisfying Maxwell's equations. So if it is clear, let us move ahead with the second example. Is E bar and H bar are given with some parameters. After completion of first example, let us move forward with the second example. First of all, we'll try to read the example. Here they have provided E bar is equal to 100 sine of 6 into 10 raised to 7 t into sine z ay bar, and H bar is equal to minus 0.1328 cos 6 into 10 raised to 70 into cos z into az bar. One more point essential or the important point I would like to hear is that all of you students can be considered to be very lucky students, because as per the syllabus structure of Solapur University, the subject was consisting of a higher level of this type of mathematics, but in case of D-2 syllabus, they have sorted out all the mathematics, but it is essential for understanding of the subject. That's why we are taking few examples, and as per our curriculum, they have concentrated on the applications of electromagnetic waves. So before continuing with the applications or further part, we have to understand Maxwell's equation at the depth by practicing these examples. Okay, so E bar and H bar are described, as here we can observe that E bar is in only one direction of AY bar and H bar is described with only one component of AZ bar. So here let us start with the first equation. First equation is del dot B bar is equal to 0 as per the example number 1. Now to check whether this equation satisfies Maxwell's equation, let us consider LHS, that is left hand side. Left hand side here we can observe del dot B bar is equal to, again B bar can be written as mu into H bar. Here I have taken directly outside instead of solving it for one or two steps. I have saved one space and I have written mu into del dot H bar. This mu can be kept aside as a constant parameter, and here H bar, sorry, here it is not AZ bar, actually it is AX bar due to that changes in the image quality. We were observing it to be AZ bar, actually please note that it is a AX bar. So here, as H bar is consisting of only AX component, we can write dou by dou X of the overall equation can be taken here for the consideration. So each and every student of you can concentrate on this step and can observe that the equation is consisting of three steps. First step is minus 0.1328, second step is cos of 6 into 10 raised to 7 t, and third step is cos of z. As easily we can observe that there is no any term related to x. Overall square bracket term can be considered to be equal to a constant for derivative with respect to x, and we can, and all of you people are knowing that derivative of constant term will be previous slide, that E bar is consisting of a parameter only in AY bar direction. That's why we'll have to consider only now. So before continuing with the third part, some students have a doubt in their mind that sir have not solved RHS and directly have written a rho v value equal to 0. Friends, we have to remember that rho v is nothing but volume charge density. In case of medium, we have to understand that rho v is a volume charge density and its value can be equal to 0 at specific places. Therefore, the value of rho v equal to 0 is also can be considered to be a true value or a practical value. Therefore, rho v equal to 0 is a practical concern. That's why we can say that del dot d bar is equal to 0 and rho v is equal to 0. Therefore, LHS can be assumed to be equal to RHS. So now, we'll proceed further to the third equation. Third equation, as we know, that it is del cross H bar is equal to J bar plus D bar. Here, as per the first or second slide, we had seen that J bar is nothing but current density. It can be expressed by sigma E bar. But here in this example, in the question itself, they have provided sigma is equal to 0. Therefore, we can write J bar is equal to 0. That's why the third set of equation will be getting converted into del cross H bar is equal to D bar dot. J bar value will be considered as 0. Now let us proceed further for solving the left hand side of the equation. So here left hand side is del cross H bar. Therefore, AX bar, as it is a curl and not divergence, we will have to consider the determinant. Every one of you people may be knowing the solution of any general determinant structure. Here, first row will be AX bar, AY bar and AZ bar. Second row will be dou by dou X, dou by dou Z and dou by dou Y and dou by dou Z. And third steps will be the terms related to H bar. Here, as we know that H bar is consisting of only AX bar component, it can be written here. If it is not readable, I will read it. You can remember it. It is minus 0.1328 into cos of 6 into 10 raised to 7 t into cos z. As equation is consisting of only x bar component, y and z components are represented equivalent to 0. Moving ahead, we write or we can solve the equation by determinant method. X bar can be kept as it is. Derivative of 0 with respect to y and derivative of 0 with respect to z will be equal to 0 minus 0. Second step will be minus ay bar. Here we have to find out the derivative of 0 with respect to x. Its value is 0 minus, here we can observe, as here we can see that there is 1 minus in the equation and 1 minus in the solution form. 1 minus is outside of this step, that is minus ay bar, and next is 0 minus 0.1328 into cos of 6 into 10 raised to 70 into sin z. Okay, so here minus of minus will be getting plus, and plus into minus will be again being minus. I will repeat once again, minus ay bar is as it is, then derivative of 0 with respect to x will be 0 minus derivative of this step with respect to z. Minus of minus was actually here plus, as this cursor is pointed over, but here all of we people are knowing that derivative of cos z with respect to z, it will be minus sin z, and again this plus is getting converted into minus. In the last step, we can observe this minus of ay bar and minus of inside bracket again will be minus of minus plus. Therefore, LHS is coming out to be 0.1328 into cos 6 into 10 raised to 70 into sin z ay bar. Now, let us move ahead towards the right hand part. So, right hand part is d bar dot. In previous lecture, we had seen that this dot is indicating dou by dou t. It is nothing but the partial derivative of the given function. Therefore, instead of writing dot, we can write dou by dou t. And therefore, d bar is equal to epsilon e bar. And we can write epsilon into bracket. Value of e bar is 100 sine of 6 into 10 raised to 70. Into sin z ay bar. I think everybody can solve this derivative, and epsilon keeping as it is, sin z also will be as it is, derivative of sin z will be cos z, and the equation will be this. Now also here we have to note that in the lecture or in the previous lecture we had seen that they had mentioned the value of epsilon is 2.5 into epsilon 0. Therefore, epsilon is written as 2.5 into epsilon 0 multiplied by this epsilon 0 value is nothing but 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12. 100 as it is, derivative of sine is cos, 6 into 10 raised to 70 as it is, sin z as it is, ay bar as it is, but as it is a composite function, the derivative of internal function will be 6 into 10 raised to 70, and its internal function derivative is to be multiplied, its value will be 6 into 10 raised to 7. Now, cos as it is, sin z as it is, ay bar as it is, and solving all the numerical concern, that is 2.5 multiplied by 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12 multiplied by 100 multiplied by 6 into 10 raised to 7 will be contributing to 0.1328. This also can be solved by you people as a practice on calculators or your mobile phones using scientific version. And we can observe here that equation 3 and equation number 4, LHS and RHS, both are exactly same, and we can say that third set of equation is also satisfied as LHS is equivalent to the RHS. Now last but not least, let us proceed further towards the fourth set of equation, which is described by del cross E bar is equal to minus B bar dot. For this equation, let us consider LHS. In case of LHS, we can observe it is del cross E bar, as we had seen as per the previous information, that del cross E bar is nothing but the curl of the given vector, which is consisting of AX bar, AY bar, AZ bar, dou by dou X, dou by dou Y and dou by dou Z. And as E bar is consisting of only AY bar component, it will be represented at the middle. X bar component is 0 and AZ bar component is also 0. In this equation, we can write AX bar as it is. Derivative of 0 with respect to Y is taken 0, and derivative of the overall component with respect to Z can be represented as 100 as it is, sin 6 into 10 raised to 70 as it is. Derivative of sin Z is simply cos Z, and we can write along with the minus sign as minus 100 sin of 6 into 10 raised to 70 into cos Z into AX bar. And for the right hand side, which is minus B bar dot, let us represent minus B bar dot as minus dou by dou T of B bar, minus dou by dou T as it is, into B bar can be expressed as mu H bar. This mu can be kept aside, minus sign will be as it is. Therefore, substituting the value of H bar, minus 0.1328 into cos of 6 into 10 raised to 70 into cos Z AX bar. I think few of you people have solved the derivative with respect to T, and please check answer. It will be coming out to be minus as it is, minus 0.1328. Derivative of cos is minus sign, which is changing the sign inside bracket from minus to plus, and cos Z as it is, AX bar as it is, but as per the previous example, here we have to multiply by the derivative of internal function, that is 6 into 10 raised to 7. One question is present in each in every student's mind, that from where this 10 came into existence. Here at the starting of this example, the question was provided with the information mu is equal to 10 mu 0, similar to the value of epsilon is equal to 2.5 epsilon 0. Then solving this step completely, we can write, or after multiplication of this 10 mu 0, what is value of mu 0? Value of mu 0 is 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 multiplied by this 10 value, and solving all the parameters, we can get minus 100 sin 6 into 10 raised to 7 t into cos z ax bar. As we can observe here, LHS and RHS equations are one and the same. From right hand side, we can write LHS is equal to RHS, and we can say that these sets of equations E bar and H bar completely satisfy Maxwell's equations. If necessary, you can repeat this video for a number of times so that the value can be observed clearly and you can understand the concept totally. So one example had been given by me at the last that can be solved here. It is a time for solving homework example. Many of you people might have solved this example. Let us complete slowly and effectively so that it will be clear to everyone. The example was defined with D bar and B bar. Whatever are the terms in the bracket, here first of all we have to observe that instead of E bar and H bar, we have to consider D bar and B bar values, because D bar and B bar are nothing but the flux densities, and instead of E bar and H bar, they have provided D bar and B bar. It will be somewhat simpler to us in a few steps, and some conversion will be required to be manipulated, that we will do it. So let us start with the first. So here we'll consider the first set, that is del dot B bar is equal to 0. Okay, here let us consider LHS. So left hand side is del dot B bar. So what is B bar? B bar is minus 754 Z minus 4.52 into 10 raised to 10 T into A Y bar. Out of that, I will consider the only bracket terms, because it is a divergence, that we know that derivative with respect to y for the ay bar component is to be considered. And as here everyone can observe, the square bracket term is not consisting of any y component. That's why overall term inside the square bracket will be treated as a constant. Its derivative will be equal to 0, and we can say that first equation is satisfied. Moving towards the second equation, we can write del dot D bar is equal to rho v. As here, similar to the first equation verification, we can write del dot D bar is equal to dou by dou x into D bar. As D bar is given directly, we can write z plus 6 into 10 raised to 7 t. As also here we can see there is no any x bar component, we can write the derivative of the square bracket equal to 0. And as per the previous example, we can say that second equation is also satisfied. Raised to minus 7 into x bar. If you will solve on your calculators, you can find this value as 6 into 10 raised to 7 x bar. Now we are reaching towards the concluding part of our lecture. Only one set of equation is remaining that can be solved as here. For right hand side of the third set of equation, we can write d bar dot as per the previous calculation, we can write this dot as dou by dou t into d bar. And therefore dou by dou t of d bar, here d bar is 6 into 10 raised to z plus 6 into 10 raised to 7 6 into 10 raised to 70 as it is. And here derivative of the square bracket with respect to t will be having value 0 for z, and derivative of 6 into 10 raised to 7 t will be only 6 into 10 raised to 7 into x bar as it is. Everybody can observe here and can easily say that as LHS and RHS, both the equations are having right hand side same, we can write LHS is equal to RHS. We can write only 6z plus 6 into 10 raised to 70, middle slide will be middle sign will be minus plus az bar into 0 minus 0, because derivative of 0 with respect to x will be 0, and derivative of z plus 6 into 10 raised to 70 will be with respect to y again will be equal to 0. Here this 1 minus of minus will be plus 1. If we'll solve effectively, we can consider the value of epsilon 0 as 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12. By simplification, we'll be getting 4.519 into 10 raised to 10 as into AY bar as it is. Lastly, we will solve for minus B bar dot, or for RHS will be equal to minus as it is into time derivative of B bar. That's why dou by dou t as it is, B bar can be substituted, and here we can observe that z component with respect to t will be 0 and derivative of minus 4.52 into 10 raised to t with respect to time value will be equal to 4.52 into 10 raised to 10. Minus of minus will be getting converted into plus into Ay bar. Again, we can observe that one equation is having LHS 4.519 into 10 raised to 10 and RHS is having value 4.52. Similar to the manner that if one student is having 519 rupees and another student is having 520 rupees, we could say that both are having equal amount of money. In the similar way, 4.519 and 4.52 can be considered to be equivalent, and approximately I will write LHS is equal to RHS, and thus as all the Maxwell's equations are satisfied by the given set, they are said to be satisfy the Maxwell's equation. So this will be the conclusion of our today's lecture. I think the part is clear to each and everyone. Definitely this will not be so simpler that you can observe, you can remember, and each and every mathematical step will be clear to you. For that purpose, what you will have to do is you have to take a pen and paper, you have to write the example, and you have to start once again. If you are able to derive these equations at the correct level, then we can say that all the Maxwell's equations are clear to all the students, or you have been made clear with the required Maxwell's equations. Hope that all the students will practice well so that Maxwell's equations will be clear in each and every student's mind, which will be the background or which will be the very basic term essential for understanding of electromagnetic waves. So thanking you all the friends, and let us stop here and we'll continue with few examples in the next lecture, and we'll start with the further part soon. Okay, thank you. Stay home, stay safe.